I was a professional bikini model. I did numerous shows from winning the Arnold Classic in 2012 to turning pro and becoming an IFBB professional athlete.
Francine Slobodnik went from being at the top of her game, strutting her stuff, to barely able to stand.
Because it's really hard to pinpoint when I felt sick, but I would say around 2019 is when I really started to get sick. From tremors to night sweats, you name it, I had it.
After going to doctor's appointments, Francine couldn't find a reason for her ailments until social media led her to a support group for women suffering from breast implant illness.
A lot of girlfriends of mine had implants and had them removed and felt better. And I joined a Facebook group where I was able to see over 100,000 women sharing their stories, verbatim, very similar to mine.
After having her implants for more than 7 years, Francine says she was sure they were the cause of her symptoms and was ready to get them out in order to feel better.
I thought, why not? I have nothing to lose besides getting my health back.
We're seeing women come here that 15, 20 years have been so sick and didn't know why.
Laura Bowden is a breast implant illness advocate at Pryor Health in Rockford.
I'm able to counsel a little bit and discuss with them a little bit what I have been through, and hopefully just kind of guide them in their journey to let them know that they're not alone.
She's also a breast implant illness survivor who's dedicated her life to raising awareness and getting more doctors to believe women who fall sick from their implants.
There needs to be more studies done. So more doctors are behind this, but we have these women so very ill and they get their implants out and they get better. That's cause and effect right there. We can't make this up.
Because it's not a really well-established diagnosis, there's not a lot of physicians that are familiar with it, and there's not a lot of surgeons and plastic surgeons that treat those kinds of patients because there's a paucity or a lack of science to support it.
Dr. Landon Pryor has seen hundreds of women fall ill from breast implant illness. His own BII Facebook support group has more than 400 members and counting.
We continue to see more and more patients that were sick, and after talking with patients about expectations for removing the implants and not obviously making any guarantees or promises, we saw that almost universally patients got better. Some of them with miraculous recoveries like Francine.
Dr. Pryor removed Francine's implants nearly 11 weeks ago, something she says saved her life.
When I first came here, I was hunched over, I had extreme chest pain. Now I'm actually able to carry a conversation, smile, feel happy. It's a complete transformation, it really is.
While BII isn't a recognized illness, Dr. Pryor is working to collect research to better understand what establishes a diagnosis so more doctors will be able to treat women who fall sick.
To have a doctor that believes, says that you're not crazy, that's huge in the breast implant illness world.
I'm trying to do what I think is going to be in our patients' best interest, and if I see that, you know, doing the surgery is helping patients, then I'm going to continue to do it. Hopefully we'll get the science to support it.
From bikini modeling to now being a breast implant advocate and a survivor, I would have never expected this, but I'm thankful that I got a second chance and that Dr. Pryor and his staff believed in me enough to move forward with the surgery.